Lieutenant Green, do we have the lab report on Macy's clothing?
It's just come in, sir. Nothing significant. Nothing to help us find the transporter.
We're missing something. I know we're missing something.
Captain Scarlet and I were listening to the tape for the umpteenth time on headphones. I rewound the tape to check something.
Sir, I think I've got it. Lieutenant, let the colonel hear from 904 feet.
I know it sounds fantastic, but it struck 13.
Are you certain about this?
Sure. I had no idea of how long I'd been out, so I counted pretty carefully. It was 13.
He'd been through a rough time. Anyone in his condition could have miscounted.
Right. That's what we assume. Now, let's assume Macy counted correctly and heard Big Ben strike 13. What's the only explanation?
I'm with you, Captain. Lieutenant Green, project central London. Program a circle using Big Ben as center. And how far do you calculate, Captain?
Well, let's see. 760 miles per hour. Well, it's no more than 1,500 yards.
Use a 1,500-yard radius. How many car parks within that area, Lieutenant?
Only two that fit the description. One in Jupiter Way, the other in Park View.
Let's go, Captain Scarlet.
I don't get it.
I'll explain later.
You have less than an hour.
Have the police cleared the street?
Just the immediate area. A large-scale evacuation was impossible.
We've checked out the Jupiter Way car park. It's not here.
SIG, Captain Oker. Well, looks like it's our baby.
We'll soon know. There it is. I'll blow the door.
I backed up the SPV to a safe distance and prepared its cannon for firing. We drove inside and discovered our prize.
We've located the transporter. Request defusing procedure.
The computer checked on this, Captain. It's a long, tricky procedure, and there just isn't time. The transporter was scheduled to deliver the device to a construction site about 10 miles from your present position.
You will drive the transporter there and take it down to the prepared excavation 2 miles underground. It can be safely allowed to detonate at this point. Is that understood?
SIG, Colonel.
Your route has been cleared. You have just under 19 minutes.
One more thing. Captain Scarlet drives the transporter alone.
But, Colonel, I...
That's an order. Good luck, Captain.
Let's go.
I'll lead the way. Keep your foot down. Every second's gonna count.
Once again, the transporter was cutting through London at a ferocious speed. But this time, Captain Scarlet was in complete control. As Captain Scarlet proceeded with reckless but necessary haste, the deadly cargo was buffeted around, its anti-vibration cradle having little effect. At the next set of traffic lights, we came up against a broken-down car completely blocking our path. Time was barely on our side, and the last thing we needed now was any form of delay.
Come on, come on.
There was no time for subtlety. Using the nose of the SPV, I pushed the car out of the way, and we continued our perilous journey. I could almost feel time slipping away as we plowed on through the streets. We hadn't used our CAP radios during the journey, but when Captain Scarlet did call, he sounded as level-headed as usual.
How much further?
We must be near.
As precious seconds ticked by, we finally reached Naylor's construction site. Captain Scarlet followed the shortest route to the massive elevator unit, taking out anything in his path.
Drive straight into the elevator. I'll get to the control panel. Closing the doors, now. Hold tight. I'm sending her down flat out. Come on, get down there.
6,000, 7,000, 8,000 feet. The elevator plunged forever downwards.
Brace yourself for the impact.
Captain Scarlet had the transporter moving before the elevator doors were fully open. He headed along a service tunnel and into a vast underground cavern.
Time's running out. Get back in that lift.
40 seconds left.
Hurry it up.
35 seconds.
Take her up.
The lift seemed to be taking forever to come back up. All the while, the bomb's timer was ticking away its last few seconds. 15 seconds left, still 3,000 feet from safety. It was touch and go. 2,000 feet. As time ran out, Captain Scarlet was still in the lift shaft.
Are you all right? Captain Scarlet? Are you all right?
I will be, Captain. I will be.
A few days later, at a rooftop restaurant.
You get quite a view from up here.
It could have looked a lot different.
Yes. Say, you never did explain how you pinpointed that car park.
I've been waiting.
For what?
Midnight. Now, Macy was in the car park, which is a few yards down the street from this restaurant. He was sure he heard 13. And this could only happen at a distance of around 1,500 yards from Big Ben.
Right. But I still don't see how he heard 13.
We're sitting about a mile away from Big Ben. And the chimes we are hearing are taking approximately 4.5 seconds to reach us.
Right.
Well, Macy said he turned on his radio, remember?
Yes.
All right, let's do the same. You count, Captain Scarlet.
All right. That's 2, 3.
Now we're hearing the chimes instantaneously over this radio. The radio's here, Big Ben's over there.
I think I'm beginning to understand.
Good. Now, sound travels at 760 miles per hour. That's 7 over the radio, but only 6 live from Big Ben. But Big Ben is 1,500 yards away, so it's 4.5 seconds behind the radio.
The radio is 1 chime ahead.
10.
Now listen.
11. 12. 13.
That last chime came live from Big Ben.
13. I'll make that my lucky number.
Captain Scarlet. Scarlet.
Captain Scarlet.